never felt more small and helpless. It would take an army to defeat Sarfog. Then, she felt a gentle touch of warmth and mustered the strength to look up. The reader was still there, expressionless as always, but unwavering in their loyalty. Quill felt the depth of their connection, the strength that came with being twofold. They'd come so far, together.
My friend, I need your help. If we don't face Sarfog now, my uncle will die. And that monster won't stop until you and I are torn apart. Will you stay with me? And try.
still searched the silent halls.
Uncle? Uncle!
She called, but only her echoes responded.
Is that really you? You have to get out of here if Sarfog finds you.
Uncle, Sarfog is dead. His voice trembled as he spoke.
The glass, the reader, you've bonded. I wanted to keep you safe from all this. It is not a burden you can bear alone.
I'm not alone.
Twofold and strong.
He resigned. We're safe now, she assured him. Let's go home.
No, Quill. You've never been in more danger.
His voice faltered.
The Arcane do not end with Sarfog. The King's glass, hidden here in the castle. You must reclaim it.
Where?
We're ready. Promising beginning, indeed. For so long, another has toiled to write an end for us all. But your bond with Quill grows strong. Your fates, yet still unwritten, are now entwined. And that gives us hope. Yes, your journey together is far from over. Rest now, dear reader. We'll begin again soon.
The darkwood falls before me, with broken bough and blackened leaf. I stand where trees meet with the sky, and in the